You have made it through all of the questions. We're going to make a couple of brief announcements and then turn it back over to the candidates to make 1 minute closing statements, starting with Kirsten, then Kelly, then John. The order will be repeated later.
So we'd like to thank all three candidates for participating in tonight's forum. We're so grateful that you were all willing to engage and be responsive on issues relating to diversity, equity, and inclusion. And I have a stack of 42 more questions that we didn't get to. And I'd be delighted to share them with you so you could know what some of the questions were. I'm sorry that we didn't get to all the questions tonight. They're all wonderful questions. There's a table in the entryway with candidates' literature and other opportunities to support them should you feel inspired to do so. There's also information about Respond to Racism and LO for Love and sign-up sheets to get our emails in the back vestibule. In some cases, a forum like this culminates with endorsements. Our organizations do not endorse political candidates. We encourage you, the audience members, to write letters to the editor and talk with your friends following tonight's forum so that the broader community can get a sense for who you felt spoke well to the issues of diversity, equity, and inclusion. And now with that, you each have 1 minute for a closing statement, and we'll start with Kirsten Aird, then Kelly Calabria, then John Wallin. Please begin.
Thank you so much for being here tonight, for your graciousness as I, you know, fumble through. We are not perfect human beings, failing forward and learning together, and that's gonna be so important when we think about these things ahead of us around diversity, equity, and inclusion, and how we continue to grow and that journey. And I am excited to be on this journey on the school board. I really, really want to do this. I want to be available and listen, and we might not always agree, and I hope that's okay with you. It's gonna be okay with me, but I sure wanna talk about it and think about where we can find common ground, because I think there's a lot more things we have in common than that we don't have in common. So I'm looking forward to being on the school board, to serving you. I hope you fill out that bubble, because it still matters, so please do. And join me on this journey as we go to the next step in the Lake Oswego School District with diversity, equity, and inclusion. Thank you.
Thank you all so much for being here and being part of the process. I know it's a time commitment, and really appreciate all of you being present. So I think it's incredibly important to be comfortable talking about diversity and inclusion, and even more important to celebrate it in our everyday life. So we really need to practice what we preach here. And that starts with teaching empathy, educating everybody, and being great examples for our kids. So we must be proactive to make progress, and that's why I'm so appreciative for LO for Love and Respond to Racism. I think that they're really sending a message to everybody that we are welcome. We're welcoming diversity, and we really embrace it here in Lake Oswego. I strongly support inclusion. Bringing people together is one of my strengths as a leader. I do it in the school community and as a business owner. And I'm really an independent thinker who is committed to open lines of communication. And at this time, I'm really convinced more than ever that the school board is ready for but just perspectives. So I really ask for your vote on May 21st. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you to our great moderators, Maya and Anna Marie, and of course, Willie and Amy, and our amazing timekeepers. They only rang the bell once. throughout my 7 years, my years in this district, 7 years on the Schools Foundation, serving our kids, volunteering, and my 4 years on the board, I've been inspired by students like these, and students who ask questions, and students who are involved and come to our board. I'm just inspired by them. I'm inspired by our work, the works of LO for Love and Respond to Racism, to taking on this very challenging, sticky issue in our community and wanting to make us better. And I want to be there for that. And I want to continue this work for another 4 years. I have a lot of hope and optimism for the future with our students, with the commitment of this great community. And I ask for your vote. Thank you.